All right, so the gunner is going to do a fire at will action. It'll give them a -4 penalty to the attacks, but I can fire two starship weapons regardless of their arc. I was hoping I wouldn't have to incur that penalty. That'll do it.
But you'd still have to, you know, be an arc that could hit me.
Yeah, aft arc for the flak thrower and
then the turret.
Foil guns on the turret.
You have a DC, you have an AC of 25 because I did an evasive.
Here comes, this is fire roll, yes, this is a flak thrower, and it's a
miss. It's a miss.
And foil guns, and 27. What was your AC?
25, that'll hit.
Hey, and 20 damage there.
Okay, you see the shields barely flicker.
Yep, smaller ship, larger shields. But we got three kinds of beer on tap.
Yeah.
Huh? And a lounge. I don't know if I'm gonna get another chance to use this crap. We just dumped that other bunch.
Black cannons are fun.
All beer cans.
Dodge this.
I just wanted the cannon to in character, know where your weapons were.
Where my cannons were?
Yeah, I know that you have an aft flat cannon and the hull blades. I know where all your weapons.
What's not working for you?
The science officer button on my sheet. The computers.
Let me look at it.
Worked for me.
Yeah, the other buttons for the other crew members are working just fine.
Yeah, it worked for me. That was me testing your button.
There we go. Do this.
You got a nice computer's chip.
Alright.
So you balance your shields. And I did my scan.
Let's try stump. Try the old flip and burn.
Like it's a DC 24, I believe.
Toughy, but useful if you get it. If you fail, your starship moves forward half its speed, but does not rotate.
Yeah. I am going to use the computer for this.
Okay.
Have your captain butted, too.
Oh, the captain's got his own thing he's got to be doing in a second. On the gunner phase.
That is 25. A 25, so you flip and burn. You move up to half your speed forward, and then flip.
And just flip-a-roo, and that's where I'm at.
And then I'm going to do a flyby attack.
Hey. That means you're going to be flying right over me.
Yeah.
How fast does your ship go?
10.
Damn.
That is a 24, so I just make it. And I end facing that way.
Okay.
And do you have any computer left?
No. I use that for the piloting to get in position.
So it's a mono node?
Yeah, it's a mono.
Hey, that's better than mine. Mine can control the lights. That's a better.
Well, I figured I got one for the computer, and then the captain can kind of, like, you know, put a little pressure on some people or encourage others. Still kind of balance out.
All I have is, you know, the basic computer that came with the frame.
Wow. Wow. Radio Shack special.
It's a data pad taped to the wall.
Taped. Is it wolf taped to the wall?
Rat tape. Not even good tape.
It's all crooked, hanging off by one side.
Got lots of hair in it.
Lots and lots of hair. Okay.
And then there's another data pad taped to the reactor, and that's how we control it.
I don't know who's worse, you or goblins. All right, we're going with the coil guns, the linked coil gun.
Okay, so that's a plus 6 to hit. Whiff!
6 is so awful. We're on 4 now.
Yeah, that was the wrong button. 23, because I forgot to make it my initiative check. So I go first. So I'm going to do a flyby attack.
Alright, I would like to do another engineering thing before we get onto the appropriate phase.
Yeah.
Standard, had to work to shields. Since I still have damage shields, now I'm not going to use the computer. Yes, that makes it better. Strides, I'm going to update my thing, and then I'm all set for the engineer. Oops. Go ahead with helm phase.
Okay, flyby attack. That's a successful flyby.
Chill.
That would be another target on the forward shield.
We use the science officer to travel on.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to do an encourage.
Is everyone just standing around watching the pilot do everything?
Doing a couple things. They're at their stations. It's just the pilot going on.
You know, playing Galaga.
Basically. They're here to fix any major holes in the ship.
That one guy on the
at Avengers.
That, yeah, on the helicarrier. You gotta think it's gotta be like that, right?
Right.
When they're not in battle, they don't need all those crew members there.
Okay, so that encourage action work.
Man, do you run any games?
Yes.
Do anyone play?
Yes.
You got 20 damage coming at your front, by the way.
Do anyone survive? That's a different question.
Ah, okay. You're one of those GMs.
Only if you make stupid decisions. I don't like killing people. I'll knock you butt out a lot if you're an idiot.
I don't like killing people with my NPCs. Love it.
Oh, NPCs, yeah, they're cannon fodder.
Let me see.
I'm assuming the remaining three members of your crew are still fighting the robots.
Absolutely. I'm sorry I didn't mention that. But yeah, you get one more good hit on them, and one of them's going down.
Activate self-destruct.
You crazy? Dwarves have put that in. Okay, what is it? Pilot action.
Nice.
Well, Triage, I am offering a digital handshake to you, sir.
I accept the digital handshake. I did not expect this to work so well.
It definitely worked well. You have a gift for ship builds.
Yeah, this was very entertaining.
I only stayed up till 6 a.m. making the ship. I don't think I need the adamantine alloy for the armor.
Probably not. Your shields really take care of everything. And you've got...
are so great.
You've got multiple science actions and officers there, so you always have the option of balancing out a really damaged shield. You've got more than enough surplus.
And each of my crew have 8 resolve.
I was looking at my notes like midway through, and my guys have 8 resolve too.
Yeah, because...
I thought it was lower for some reason.
It's the base stat, so whatever your primary stat is. So for me, dexterity. The modifier plus half your level.
Yeah, more likely it's always going to be maxed out.
Did you just make like carbon copies of your pilot?
They're actually a little different. The pilot had to spend most of her money on her data jack.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was 8,000 credits right there.
Did you do your whole operative idea or no?
Yes.
Oh, you did.
So they'd be terrifying.
They're all operatives, and they're all ghost operatives, you said?
Ghost operatives.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So for the first 10 rounds of combat, they'd have cloaking fields. Plus 10 to their stealth checks.
Alright, well.
Yeah.
I'm gonna call it. This was great. I hope the audio and recording everything turns out great. We'll see how it turns out.
I definitely want to watch that.
Yeah.
Maybe maybe add in a little bit of mood music.
I had been from
Star Trek or something.
I was talking to the I forget his name, Ducky, and I said that because he was, you know, he does a lot of voice acting work, and I was like, man, you're giving me ideas. Like, I'm thinking like ESPN of Starship Combat, like, welcome back to the action. And you have like stuff like that. Why did he do a play like that? Well, let's take a look at this, you know?
And one thing that I like about my ship is I'm going to make it so there's actually no lights on the ship because all of my crew have dark vision.
Oh,
Why waste power on lights when you don't need them?
Doesn't really come into play in the sense of it, but that's a cool idea.
I mean, if you board the ship, there's no lights.
Yeah. As the boarding rules seem to go, like, if someone were using boarding pods on you,
right?
Like, all your ghost abilities and stuff doesn't seem to come into play.
Not unless it's a tactical combat.
Exactly.
So I bet you that if I click a weapon, your gunner's not going to work.
That's how I do my mob.
Really?
Yeah.
No, you did your number first and then the name.
No, I didn't.
Yeah. Shut up.
Yeah.
Huh, okay. Well, hope Sonana's going to edit all this out. All right, I'm going to shut up. All right, guys. This was great. I really liked it. Thank you very much. All right, well, Sonana, we can end the recording. Let's thank the listeners for sticking it through.